This is the Wasatch Mountains, a big prominent mountain range in northern Utah. We're at the northern end of the range, between Brigham City and Ogden, little town of Willard down there. Willard Bay is a freshwater part of the Great Salt Lake that's kind of separated from the salty part of the lake. And we're kind of high over Willard Canyon here in this really spectacular setting. And the main purpose of this video, I hiked quite a ways up here, no trail, excuse my sweaty appearance here. But this is one of the more spectacular locations along the Wasatch Front. One of my personal favorites because it's so jagged and just really rugged, just a really rugged landscape. And there's a really special geologic feature up here that people drive by all the time. I mean, we've got I-15 down there, so people going north and south on the freeway. There's a really amazing geologic feature up here that I wanted to do a video on. That probably doesn't look like much to the naked eye until you understand a little bit more about what it means. And so we'll kind of get right to it here. We can see sort of a sharp contact between these dark rocks below and these lighter kind of cream colored rocks above. The same contact is right here along my feet. There's these really dark looking rocks down in here. And then if I just swing over just behind me here, here's these cream colored rocks. And so you can see this sharp contact going up the hillside. You kind of lose it as you come down towards Willard Canyon, and then the contact dives underneath the cream colored rocks to the north, but you can trace it further to the south. And what this is something called an unconformity. An unconformity is where we have a rock getting deposited or some older rock that exists, and then it gets eroded and then younger rocks get deposited on top. Unconformities are really common, and usually they can represent anything from a few thousand years, a few million years, maybe tens of millions of years, or even a couple hundred million years. But what makes this specific unconformity so special is how much time it represents. So if we look at these rocks here below us, these brownish rocks here, these are old granites, metamorphic rocks. You can see some of these rocks have some layering to them, gneisses and schists, that sort of thing. These rocks are 1.8 billion years old. They're from the Archean Eon, and these rocks are among some of the oldest rocks we have in Utah and in Western North America. There's rocks that are a little bit older, but not by a lot. And these rocks, being metamorphic rocks, they form at tremendous depths and under tremendous temperatures and pressures. So these rocks formed way down under the Earth's crust, tens of miles down, and then they were at some point brought up to the Earth's surface. These rocks represent a big collisional event. 1.8 billion years ago, two continents collided, and these rocks represent the old rocks in that collision that were down well below the mountain. So at the top of the mountain, you'd have maybe younger rocks and folds. These were the sort of the core or the old basement rocks that sat underneath that mountain range. Of course, that mountain range has been long eroded 1.8 billion years later, but these rocks have been brought to the surface. So 1.8 billion years below our unconformity. And then we get to these kind of cream colored rocks here. This is a quartzite, and quartzites are basically sandstones that have just been compressed a little bit more, buried and sort of fused together. But essentially these are sandstones, and these are from the Cambrian period, about 540 million years ago. So what makes this unconformity so special and amazing is how much time is wrapped up in this one contact right here. So here we have the older metamorphic rocks, and then sitting right above them, the cream colored beige sandstone or quartzites. So this contact I'm touching here represents about 1.3 billion years of Earth's history. Essentially, you know, about a third or so, a little less than that, of the Earth's history is encapsulated by this one unconformity. And because this unconformity represents such a huge amount of time,
We call it the Great Unconformity. It actually gets a special name. And we find it in a few other places. It's the same unconformity you find at the bottom of the Grand Canyon. You can find it in the Tetons as well. But it's really only exposed in the west, wherever we have a lot of uplift, like we've had here in the Wasatch Range, or enough erosion, as in the case with the Grand Canyon, to expose this. So really pretty cool when you think about it. Rocks that were once below a big mountain range, these crystalline rocks, these granites and metamorphic rocks, and then sitting above them, rocks that were deposited as sand on a beach. These Cambrian rocks were actually deposits of sand along the shoreline of ancient Western North America. So 1.3 billion years wrapped up in this unconformity, which is really pronounced as you drive on I-15. Take a look to the east when you can, and you'll see this really sharp contact between these dark metamorphic rocks, these Precambrian rocks, what we call basement rocks because they're usually so deep, and then these 500 million year old quartzites, these sand deposits along the edge of North America. I want to show you a little bit more of the Cambrian rocks here. So we're going to kind of hop over this little ridge and make our way across this little start of this talus field here. I think I'm actually going to try to go down that way, which might be a lot easier than the brushy section I came up through. So we can actually see here, there's layering in these Cambrian quartzites. These are essentially sedimentary deposits. So they're laid down in layers. Across the way there, you can see how well bedded they are, the prominent bedding there. They're all kind of dipping or tilted in this direction here to my right, which is to the northeast. But these beds of sand are pretty dominant in here, but in places, what we can see is a different type of unit. So in places, what you actually see are these rounded particles of quartz. These are just gravels. These were gravels that were laid down when the river systems that were depositing these were a little bit more energetic. You can see a whole bunch of these just beautiful, colorful pebbles all in the in with the sandstone or the quartzite here. Another nice bed down here. Here you can actually see, you know, it's more sandy up here, and then there's a nice prominent bed of the quartzite there. And then you can actually trace these down along the layers going down. So one of my favorite spots, kind of a bear to get to. There is a trail that comes up Willard Canyon. So maybe in hindsight, I might have hiked that and then come up the talus. I think I'm going to go down that way. There are places you can see the unconformity and be a little bit closer to it, but this is one of the rare places where you can really just put your hand on that sharp contact that represents 1.3 billion years of time. So really awesome place here in the Wasatch, and I hope you enjoyed learning a little bit here. Willard Canyon in the Wasatch Mountains.